Welcome back. Well, we've all heard of so-called Nigerian princes scamming people out of money on the other side of the world. But what if your scammer turns out to be someone you're dating? Well, that actually happened to Studio 10 regular and radio host Mel Greig in what can only be described as the date from hell. And she joins us now from our studio in Wollongong. Hey, Mel.
Hi, guys.
Now, let's start from the beginning, because you went on one date with this bloke and then he moved in with you. How did that happen?
Yeah, look, when you say it like that, Sarah, I should probably be slapping myself in the face going, why? Why did you do that? The thing is, with this guy, he's a master manipulator. So halfway through the date, which was going extremely well, he was getting along with everyone, he gets this mysterious message where he's left on the streets and has nowhere to stay. I've had a few wines. I'm like, eh, babe, it's fine. Just move in with me just for a couple of days until you find somewhere.
Yeah.
So that's what he did. And then within a few days, it turned very bad.
Yeah, wow. But hindsight's, you know, it's always
2020.
It's easy to say in hindsight, and the dating world is awful, isn't it? But when you look back now, Mel, like, has it taught you something in terms of, you know?
Yeah, I think you always have to go, okay, this is a really bad situation. What can I learn from it? And for me, a few days into him staying with me, I lent him $1,000. And up until that point, he was telling me about his mental health problems. And I gave this guy unconditional kindness. And I made sure that that experience hasn't ruined it for me in other aspects of my life in terms of helping other people. Because since this has happened, so many women have come forward that have been scammed as well by this guy.
It's extraordinary, Mel, and you are a very lovely and trusting person, so please stay that way.
Yeah.
But he had a really elaborate kind of backstory, didn't he? He wasn't just someone who said, hey, can you give me $1,000? Like, he made up this whole rigmarole. he orchestrated text messages that he would then pretend to respond to, I think, from his dad and all sorts of things. Tell us a bit about this scam.
Yeah, it was crazy, and you believed it. He was so good at it because he believes what he's saying, like he thinks it's the truth because he's a pathological liar. So he says that his bank account has been hacked and he can't believe it. And mind you, this guy at the time, he's now been dismissed, had a high-paying sales manager job. I saw his payslip, so I saw that he had money, but his money was going in other areas that he was still ripping off from people. So apparently his bank account is hacked, but his dad's going to give him some money. Then the bank's meant to pay him back. Then he loses his bank cards, and it's this chain reaction of bad luck. And you're like, God, this guy, he can't catch a break. You know, that's all right. Do it next week. Pay me back. And 2 months later, I haven't seen my money, but I'm one of the lucky ones. Some other girls are thousands of dollars.
And he also appeared to target wealthy or high-profile women, didn't he? I mean, he sort of seemed to know his...
mark.
His mark.
Yep, because he ripped off a doctor who works at one of Sydney's busiest hospitals. You know, this lady... Not that I'm not intelligent, but this is a doctor, you know? Mm. This is a different level of intelligence, of pay grade, and he still managed to manipulate her, and that's what he goes for. And the moment he targeted me, I'd just done an article saying that I was feeling vulnerable and lonely, but he mistook that kindness for weakness, which was his downfall, because I'm not going to let him get away with it.
Oh, what a scumbag, Mel, honestly. And is it true that he's actually made threats against you since all of this has come out?
Yes, he has, and it's not the first time he's made a threat against a woman either. He's an absolute scumbag, and to him, I'm absolutely not scared of you. You can threaten me all you like because you're weak, and I'm not going to stand for it because you don't get to talk to a woman like that. And he just needs... The best place for him is jail. He can't get help. He's been into places before. It didn't work. Jail is where he needs to be, so I hope that enough women come forward that we can build a strong case and get him locked up.
What are some of the natures of these threats that he's made against you, Mel?
Just for my life, so I can stop...
he's threatened your life.
What he says is defaming him.
Oh, gosh.
Yeah, he threatened my life, but it's not the first time he's done that. This is what he does. And for me, I've heard threats before, so I just try and take it for just a weak person acting out, and I'm not trying to take it too seriously because I'm not going to let him make me paranoid and look over my shoulder every 2 seconds because that's what he wants. He wants me to be scared and vulnerable.
Well, good on you.
Well, lesson learnt there, love. Don't take a guy home on the first night. Look, I have to say, no, we've all done it. Let's face it.
No.
But has this turned you off dating, sweetheart?
You know what? I text Sophie Monk last night. I'm like, Beb, can you share those leftovers if you don't want them? I'll take some of those rejected men. So.
Oh, Mel.
No. Well, I mean, you can only improve from a scam artist, so we'll see.
No, but good on you. I just want to say good on you for speaking out about it. Yeah. Because it does
helping
go
other
on
women.
And we're all, we've all been in awful situations and we're embarrassed and ashamed. And good on you for not letting this...
Absolutely, Mel. And can you tell us, where's the case at now?
Is Mr. Scumbag.
Is he being prosecuted? Is it before...
Well, he has the other case against one of the other women for something unrelated and something that is completely heinous. If I could tell you what it is, you'd be mortified. That's coming up really soon. And then after that, there's going to be... I mean, I've filed with police, but now it's about everyone getting on board, filing for fraud and making this scam stop.
Oh, Mel Greig.
Well, it's good luck with it.
It's an awful story, but we're glad that you're standing strong after it and love is still out there for you. We can obviously hear
you
every morning on Wave FM in Wollongong. Mel Greig, everyone.
Thank you. Thanks.